Spaghetti squash, an alternate to the normal pasta for carb. It got really quiet. I was hiking and sometimes I trip. I fell straight into a pothole. Luckily this one didn't have any water and algae at the bottom. Then I was stuck and no one came to rescue me.
We're all too
show
busy.
The faces.
Of the too busy laughing.
Look up. Abby's fine. Get off of Abby.
Harry tried.
He was a hero.
She's too little. Harry tried.
All heroes wear capes.
I thought that Harry should also know what it feels like to be trapped in the pothole. Meanwhile, I'm super stuck in the pothole and everyone's laughing.
Yeah.
So anyway, Mom. Yeah, I kind of vomited a lot.
Did you contain yourself?
She cleaned it up though.
No. I did not contain myself. It's really bad, Mom.
Are you filming?
Very embarrassing. Yes, Abby, she's filming.
Yep, I am.
You know, at least I almost made it to the toilet.
There it is. There it is.
Thanks for sharing, honey.
You're welcome, Mom.
Yeah, honey.
Okay, so Abby, let's talk about what we're out here doing. So, Abby, you decided that the most
qualified.
Appropriate, most qualified choice for president in this room is clearly
clearly
Emma. So Maddie decided to.
So we're doing campaign signs.
Yes.
Different designs. Emma will be turning 34 in 2027. It's early.
So she'll be able to run and then be 35 in office. We think that's how it works from American government in 2009.
Not exactly.
Okay.
This was kind of some preliminary.
Not qualified.
sketches that I did. Just really for visual people that want to know more about Emma's platform.
Yeah.
Okay. So then this is all about Emma's platform. So I did a little, one of these.
An acrostic.
Yeah. Acrostic.
Yeah.
Okay, so Emma. E. Everyone must have cats.
I feel like must should be underlined.
Must have more cats. M. Murdered if you don't have cats.
I like it.
A, absolutely need cats.
What are you on the side there?
2027, endorsed and sponsored by the I Love Cats 27 Fund.
All right, boys, you're up.
Okay. So I just went a little simple route, just have a little phrase, a little picture, just to show it's something I love to use all the time. But the thing about the campaign for Emma, we need to get empowered. Let's get lit.
Yeah!
Now, hear me out here. For those of you who need the visual, we have this little fire here.
It's lit!
And you know, I didn't just want to do the, you know, boring orange and red for the fire. So I decided I'll light in purple because that's more lit.
Yes!
So purple's more lit.
I love
here.
That cursive there.
Oh, and then I had to bring out the cursive because Emma wants cursive in the schools.
Oh! Old school.
Yeah.
No coding for these kids.
Nope. Just... No. No. We are manually doing handwriting.
Yes.
Relevant.
Billy, it's all you.
It's kind of hard to follow.
Okay, well, Michael prefaced that mine is pretty much the same as his. Which I didn't want to, but I mean, it's a little different. We got a couple of extra things on here, so here we go. So instead of let's get lit, we have cats are lit. Now, I was only going to do just the fire. However, I figured you might not get it if I just put the fire. So I put lit underneath 2027, and our theme is going to be, we're lasering for the vote. We're see the little laser beams coming out there? We're lasering for the vote. We're lasering out the vote.
Emma's crying. 26 Emma's sobbing.
What is new? Just like your standard yard sign to get her name out.
Yep, sure.
Name recognition. So Reese 2027. Oh, hashtag love cats 27.
Yes. We need a hashtag.
Yes.
That is it. That is the hashtag. Brilliant, Nicole.
I love the energy of the room. Like random phrases.
Share that we want to really share.
Cats. A little picture of a cat. Meow. TikTok to all of
them. How did nobody come up with that yet? Nobody put meowing.
Coaches. Coaches.
First
cat of the United States.
Yes.
Cats for everyone, and she's the cat's meow.
Oh, that's
hashtag USA. That's important. Whoa. We have to include the country.
Emma, did you make one for yourself?
I did. More of the yard signs thing.
Good.
I just said Reese 2027. I love cats. You should too.
Yes. Simple. Great. Beautiful. Concise.
Good, I love it.
She's all whooped up.
Okay, can we go at the same time?
Hey. Yeah.
Ours are very similar.
Yeah.
Okay, you ready? Do you want to go first?
Okay. What I did is a simple thing called I Love Cats 2016. And right here it says Emma 27 for president. And you can find her on Facebook /USA.
There he is! Component in this campaign.
We're missing that.
I didn't even think of
Facebook.
Yes, Abby.
What was your inspiration for the 2016? Are we starting early? Is there a meeting for it?
You gotta start now.
We have to start right now.
It's true.
And I meant Hillary, Donald,
Abby,
and Emma.
Mine is the worst one of all. Okay, so here we have four cats pictured. They're pink.
Oh, wow.
We love cats 2027.
Oh, Instagram. Oh, my goodness.
Tinder. What about LinkedIn? What about Snapchat?
Okay, we're ready. I'm ready. I've had this on here all along. We love cats 2027. Follow on Twitter /USA. Follow on Instagram /USA. Follow on all dating apps.
Nice.
Emma for POTUS. There it is.
I'm up for president 2027. Cats are lit. Let's get lit. Laser for the vote. Pew, 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 pew
Lady Minnesota.
We're taking over Lady Minnesota's Instagram.
Catch us from 3 to 6 p.m.
Luke's that? Leaving to go to Europe in like how many hours? 48 hours?
Yeah, 48. Skirt. Skirt, skirt.
Listen to this Dave Matthews Band putting us in the mood.
We're in Delano's.
We're in Delano's. Delano's. Pizza.
Two for ones all
day. Two
night.
For ones.
All day, every day.
Kath, we need to come here. There's karaoke. Is there karaoke tonight? Comedy night? We should come here for karaoke sometime.
Wait, we should. What night?
It's Monday and Tuesday.
Monday, Tuesday. Cure those Monday blues.
It's two we for should. Ones all day, every day.
Except uptown.
Yeah, that's true. It's in your uptown.
Thing. This is great. This is a great location. They have a touch tube.
They have a jukebox. The floor reminds me of like a bowling alley. Or like a hotel.
I love it.
This is not Summit. It's just in a Summit glass.
Poser.
Well, That's all I have to say.
We'll bring it out later. And some shots. Probably not.
Probably not. I have to get up at 7 a.m. Okay, bye.
I'm gonna call Shannon on the phone.
Dang, that smells so good.
It looks so good.
I don't know if I'm gonna cut it. We're just gonna dig in.
Just dig in.
Okay, perfect. Yeah. Well, you have to pose with it at least. And you have to say, like, happy fall.
Happy fall. You guys, like, get these apples. You hand plucked.
I wish we went to an apple orchard.
I mean, we should get some apples.
Walk around with it a little bit.
Happy fall.
Yes! I'll put it on Mackenzie.
The most interesting thing is how much I really don't like cats and how bad cats are, is all I've learned.
Wait, why? Because you're like dissecting them?
No, because they cause so many diseases.
What? Truth. Like what?
When I got bit by a dog, they're like, luckily it wasn't a cat. Mm-hmm. I'm like, why? And they're like, because you could like lose your leg. And I'm
like, cats bite you or they scratch you. And because they're like outside, they have all these diseases inside of them. And then they give it to you and you could like wake up the next morning with your whole hand swollen.
Wow, I hate cats too, so yep. That's good to know.
And when you're pregnant, they can give you diseases from your feces.
Yeah, I've heard about that.
That's why it's good to be pregnant when you have a cat, then you don't have to ever clean it.
You don't have to clean it, right? Yeah.
Because that's one good part of the cats, but I don't like multiple reasons why you shouldn't like cats.
Thank you for that fun fact.
There is a commercial, and they play it every single year on Christmas. And it's like this family having Christmas dinner, and the Christmas tree is outside. It's like an outdoor tree, and it smells the green bean casserole, and it like shoves its little prickly arm through the window, and then it like pulls it out of the window. Like they set it on the window, and they nobody's seen this.
No,
I've never been so disappointed in any of you.
Sorry,
it's
Kat.
So good. I'm gonna find it on YouTube.
Green bean casserole.
Kanye like pushed him off.
You were on the general admission floor. Yes. Was it desirable to be underneath the floating stage?
Hell no.
No. You wanted
I found that out the hard way in the beginning.
Okay. So you did not want to be under it.
Well, like I was for a little bit and then first of all, there were so many boys there and I was like, I can't, but also I was like, I wanna be here.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, crowd was like, jumping around.
Yeah.
And I'm like, not me.
Okay.
So I kind of backed out to the edges.
Yeah.
And that was good. That was the right place to be because I had my own room. I was jumping. I was dancing.
Yeah.
I was screaming.
Now,
that was good.
My other question is this. So were people, when they were underneath the stage, were they getting like crazier than when they were not underneath the stage? Is that what you're saying?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
so if you were under like, it, people are going in. Crazy. Oh.
There was like. Six
you
bodyguards
could...
that were always under the stage the whole time. So every time it moved, they would to make sure like it didn't get rowdy and people didn't like
break
each other.
Because
you know?
There was that vine of that guy who jumped on it.
Yeah.
Dramatic.
Kanye had that like vocalizer or whatever shit going on, so I didn't know what he was saying every time he spoke.
Oh.
Like every time he sang, I'm like,
every time he spoke, it was like auto-tuned.
Yeah.
Really?
And
they like shut it off.
Mm. Or they did, but I don't really like. I couldn't really understand what he was saying because he was just like going off or something. He like was going off about famous, and I'm like, yes, yes.
You could, and when you weren't under, you could see him like pretty much just fine, mm-hmm. depending on where you were.
Oh my god, I got like so close to him first.
Yeah, yeah. I saw your snap.
I was like, oh my god, but I couldn't really see because the lighting was kind of.
Could you see through the stage?
No.
No.
It was like lights.
What? Lemon juice and water and honey. You should make us this drink for
Oh, it's
throat.
My mug.
Is that your mug?
I lost that mug.
I wondered where it came from.
Oh no, my battery died.
Good.
We're out here at the local Faribault Walmart and we came across something shocking.
Nick Jonas, what is this? What did you do? How does this exist? When was this made?
This was made in
where's the copyright date? 2016. Apparently this is a recent film that literally no one heard of.
Okay, so we are up. Attention, greetings. This is the Levels Pod minus one. We are about to pull off the best prank of the year.
Oh no.
On Shannon Oz, our best friend.
A power move.
And we are going to sneak up to her bedchamber and...
Oh my god!
We're gonna put this DreamWorks Trolls...
DreamWorks Twos.
Otherwise known as DreamWorks Twos.
I can't believe you.
Poster on her boudoir. And it's gonna be really funny.
I'm so happy.
Else think
this is
I'm
so.
I can't believe you went to these
lights. I literally.
Once again.
I go to extremes, Billy Joel.
I go to extremes.
I go to extremes, Billy Joel. Okay, should we go out there?
Trolls.
DreamWorks Twos. I wish that you would have like done this to me somehow. This is a great prank.
I think it's so cute.
She's gonna die. She's gonna be like, what
the? Facing her.
The quality on this video right now is very spooky.
Spooky legend.
I'm getting like just across here.
Yes.
I think that's effective. Will you help me hold this up?
On her boudoir.
Should we like take the back? Yeah.
What do you mean?
I do that shit as well. Okay, stay exactly where you are, Luke.
I'm not moving.
This is some revenge for her not hanging out with us tonight.
Oh.
I'm kidding, she hasn't ever done
this. This is a gift. What are you talking about?
You're right. It is a gift.
It is a gift. Did you like see this arrive?
No, I...
Did you order this?
No, Ellie and I found it at the Faribault Walmart.
Oh my god, why didn't you purchase one for me? I want one.
they have one that has all the characters' names.
Is this like from the movie or just the Trolls poster?
It's from the movie.
It's from the movie. Okay, you ready?
It's a DreamWorks official postal.
Yeah. The DreamWorks... Oh, it's upside down. Okay, shit. How are we gonna...
I got it. We got it. We good. We good, fam.
I cannot wait to see this film.
I hate Beavers hearing that.
Okay.
Whoa.
Yeah.
She's going to shriek.
It ain't gonna fall.
Or I hope she doesn't notice until like
the
morning.
Ew, look at their hair. Why is it connected? I don't like it. Why did anyone think making a movie about this would be good? What one?
The one with the buck teeth is Justin Timberlake.
Oh my god. Justin, how much did they pay you for this movie?
I don't know.
He's probably been very quiet lately.
Probably too much. That's why he did it.
What?
I'm excited for the orchard.
Yes. Me too. We're going to be so cold. We're gonna.
I want a bob for apples. Can we do that?
Yeah.
I've never
done it.
I feel like that would feel like you're drowning.
It's actually. Like waterboarding.
Yeah. I feel like I'm going to like chip my tooth again.
No. Yep.
Like my chip tooth is going to pop out when I bite into an apple.
Just the whole thing.
Yeah.
Probably.
The rest of it's going to
come
with it.
I don't see how you can't like partially drown when you bob for apples.
Kyle and I are famous YouTubers.
Not that famous.
Feature each other.
This is a collab.
I'm ready. Oh my god, yes. No, I was going to try it. I was gonna say, let's play a drinking game.
This is the whole point of title right now.
It's an anti-Trump rally. So.
Jellyfish.
Jellyfish. Let's make a tutorial on how to make a hammock holder.
3,000 views.
To make what?
Serious.
And how to what?
Yeah. It has
I
like...
have my most views ever is like 33.
My hammock video has like 3,000 views. It's ridiculous.
Are you making money on it?
Hey, drinking.
No, I didn't monetize it. I don't want to monetize till I hit like 50,000 subscribers.
You, monetize
that no one else in the
today.
Group shares with
no.
You.
Wait, what?
No.
I don't want to limit how many people want to watch my videos. I'm gonna wait until people are like hooked in.
Kyle's so sick. So he drinks. So he drinks.
I'll drink.
Sigourney Weaver.
James Cameron drives a Prius. That's great for the environment.
They broke up.
Kevin Spacey.
What's that?
Kevin Spacey is dating Kristen Stewart.
Tell me a tale you've never told anyone.
Okay.
You didn't tell us that Kyle knows Balloon Shop.
Oh, yeah.
We just lost our
shit. I knew
balloon
shop in like high school. Middle school.
Same.
One of us.
That's my girl. Fifth Harmony.
We should turn this off. We gotta take a selfie for our socials.
Collabing.
Oh my god.
Yup. The lovely documentarian.
Dude,
because
we're
running low.
Just,
like, it'll find the person.
It's Casper Cast.
I have multiple bows. This might be my brother's. It's loading it probably.
What?
We're working on our YouTube careers. Mom.
Yeah, f off, Mom.
His face. Zoom in. See your face.
Collab.
Wait, let me just.
I can't.
Sat it.
I hate everything about this.
We're
done.
This is the worst.
And the tweet.
Tweet
of the tweet.
The tweet.
Yes. Yes.
I look like a cartoon.
Yes. It's so funny. We're beginning.
Welcome to.
And we're back.
You deserve a drink. I'm Mamrie Hart.
Wait, I don't have the microphone on.
And today.
Dead cat.
What? I'm sorry, what?
Cat. He is a dead cat.
What?
You'll see.
No, that's just what this is.
It's a boom mic?
That's what they call it.
It's a boom
mic.
It's
literally called the dead cat.
It's the cover over the mic.
Did you guys know Rita Ora has a song called R.I.P.?
Lady Minnesota viewers, please keep in mind my production quality in comparison
cut
to this shit.
I cannot.
True inspiration here today.
Dead cat. Hashtag dead cat.
I can't do it. Okay.
This isn't everyone on YouTube.
Yes, it is.
Yeah,
okay.
It is.
You can't USB charge it at the same time that it's.
I don't care. There have been plenty of times in Lady Minnesota where I've not been edited.
This is my shit.
And it's a bit of a concern.
Tyga.
Alright.
Kat, I still need to take your sparkling cider.
You guys, Kylie Jenner was 14 when this
okay,
came
so.
Out. But never way brave.
Every time you kiss me.
Say that you miss me.
Do we need more ice?
This will be fine.
There might be a lot of ice.
Oh, I want you.
So something like this is not going on there.
My mom watches Lady Minnesota.
Hey.
Hi, Nikki.
Does she approve?
Probably not.
Collab.
Collab.
Kyle.
Cheers, y'all. Late one night, when my eyes beheld an evil sight.
For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly,
some pulp in there.
Surprise.
We are in the process of painting a yoga mat
for
Jadena. It's gonna be our sign.
Yoga.
Let your booty do that yoga. Yeah. We're gonna use it when we camp out before the Jadena concert, which is on Friday.
Woo!
What up? I love your jacket, also.
Thanks.
Off topic.
It's from United Kingdom. I just bought it this week.
What a traveler.
Yeah. Well, they shipped it. This is my 32nd time seeing Kesha.
32nd time.
Yeah, sorry.
Wow. That's amazing.
This is her autograph tattoo.
Wow.
Oh my god. What
real
a fan.
Fans,
real fans.
Real fans.
Cool.
I'm Nick.
Nick.
Okay.
Well, I'm Becca. I'm from Campbellsport, Wisconsin, which is in the middle of nowhere, Wisconsin. This is my third time seeing Kesha, and I do not have a Kesha tattoo. But one day, hopefully, I'd kiss Kesha.
Oh my gosh.
Wow. I don't have the tattoos, but...
That's a story, though. That's even better.
She's never washed her face since.
Oh. Right, never. Right. I have not showered for the past
How far did you drive?
Well, actually, I go to school in Platteville, so I drove 4.5 hours here.
Okay.
So, and 4.5 hours back home tomorrow. So, yeah.
Cool. Yeah,
I'm flying to Miami Beach in the morning to see Kesha tomorrow night, so I live in Minnesota, though.
Oh my gosh. You're like a groupie, I would argue.
I've seen her like 14 times this year, so it's a problem.
That's so great.
I have to update my list.
Yes, it's your turn. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm Harper. This is my first homecoming concert, and I am so excited.
Woo!
Cool.
Is that good?
Yeah, that was great. That was so good. Thank you.
Precise.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, ladyminnesota.com, check us out. Yeah. I'm Kathleen, by the way. This
I'm
is Shannon.
Shannon.
LA looks so iconic with these sunnies and the beanie.
It's what time is it?
So 2:36.
Summertime. It's our vacation. What time is it? Time of our lives.
Fans. Mm-hmm. Getting to know each other, just enjoying ourselves.
Yeah.
Hanging?
I got here at like 1.
I'm so excited that you did. I'm so excited that
I just like panicked and like had to leave the house. Mm-hmm. So I was nervous.
Completely valid. Yeah. Completely valid. I was like getting panicked that I was like running late. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh god.
Literally starts at like 8 p.m.
Yeah. My mom was like, you're going up right now. And I was like, yeah, we're camping out early. And she's like, what time is the concert? And I was like,
hey.
I had to use the bathroom. I felt bad, so I just popped fries.
Are you guys waiting?
Yeah. What's up?
Very cold.
Yeah.
It's
okay.
We came really prepared.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How are you, Payne?
Yeah. All right. Are you guys
here for Kesha or Jidenna?
Kesha.
All right. Big Jidenna fans.
Yeah. We're just holding down. We're just holding down the Jidenna for it.
Have you seen her before?
Yeah. We saw her back in
August.
Oh, at the show.
At Aria.
Yeah. Nice.
It's good.
Cool. That's nice. Should be a fun show.
Okay, you're actually not that bad.
Kyle's being coy.
It does, okay.
I don't know what to say today.
He was singing Jidenna all day.
Yes, good. Okay, so tell us about your Joe Bro stan days.
Hi, my name is Shannon, and I was a Jonas Brothers stan since basically they had a song on the Jungle Book back in...
Are you kidding me?
Six, maybe? Till present day, but even though the band is not together. I went to, I think, 6 or 7 shows in 4 different states. One in Minneapolis in 2009, I think. We camped outside of the Target Center. We were in the Skyway System. And I had my little portable picnic table. Probably like 8 of us girls and then 2 moms. Hanging, just eating snacks and hanging out in all in our t-shirts, getting our merch. And it wasn't even general admission, we just had our tickets and finally went to our seats. But one time in Phoenix, the line was like, they made the wait so long, and her grandma like had like a physical reaction. She had like heat stroke. So like they got the email of somebody and just like complained. And so we didn't just get meet and greet, we got like special treatment meet and greet. So we like got to be in the front of line, got as much time as we wanted, like got to get our shit signed.
Nobody makes it for my.
Yeah. 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 University of Minnesota's.
that's your crew. The booty don't lie.
What up,
those girls? Woo!
So good in your life, I swear to God. It's just working. Work.
Tide.
Dead!
Sharks everywhere. People are killing them. They're dying. It's absolutely terrible. Stop killing sharks. They're dying at an alarming rate. Millions, hundreds of millions of sharks a year. Everywhere. Especially in, like, China and stuff. Sharks.
Especially.
And they're the top apex predators of the food chain.
What's up?
I was telling her about the, you know, removing sharks from the food chain is just terrible, the carbon sequestration of the ocean.
Yeah.
Sharks. I love it.
Tell us your life story.
My life story, wow. I was actually born and raised in Minnesota, so.
Tell us.
My freshman year, I'm a senior, and my freshman year, it was like 16 below, and they canceled class. First time in like 50 years.
Yes.
Can't play this multiple times.
Back at it again. Listening to Captain Jack in the car with Patty Hearn.
You just sit at home.
This drive is so scenic.
They hear a voice in the home.
This is the heartland of America.
The bread basket. As they say, when I was in third grade, we had to make vests out of cardboard bags, or not cardboard bags, paper bags.
Yes.
And then we were all like a different region of the U.S., and we had to like draw on it and then do like a little presentation. That was the breadbasket of America.
Which is what?
Which is like the Midwest.
The bread basket.
They had like a bread.
Did you make it look like a bread basket?
Yeah, like,
oh my God, that's
bread themed.
Just classic.
Yeah, I rocked it out. I'm
classic creative.
To be honest with you, I did really well.
Hashtag creatives.
Hashtag creatives, the breadbasket of America.
Hashtag live authentic.
Should we be concerned?
We're just having fun.
It's probably just like a
uncontrolled burn.
Yeah.
Slash a bonfire.
Okay.
So you should come to our house and help us decorate.
Yeah, I was planning on it. Do you need me to bring anything besides cheddar cheese?
No, just shredded cheese.
I think so, yeah. He, like, just texted me and was like, oh, I just woke up. And I was like,
same.
I don't need to be in the house.
Okay, LA.
I'm going to go so I can purchase all of these things.
Fancy meeting you here.
Oh my God, same.
Dude,
we are having a Halloween rager at my house. Come through tonight. Yeah.
Seriously, bring your friends.
Text me, bring your friends. We're camping.
What a classic Faribault moment.
She,
holy
we looked
shit.
And then we both went, oh my God.
Holy shit, bud. Kayla, I love her.
I love her too.
I hope she comes.
Yeah,
what's Maddie Moore up to?
I don't know. You should Facebook message her my address.
Queen of Halloween.
That's probably
look at Kim.
What?
Look at Kim.
Yeah, I know.
You
Kim's
didn't even
looking...
see her.
I
you
did.
Didn't, you didn't even
didn't
say hi.
Kim.
Hello, Kim.
What's
up, guys? Don't mind me.
What?
Don't mind.
Oh, shit. He saw me.
A lot of
hard
times
with Oscar. Still filming. You guys just act like I'm filming you, and then okay, hold on.
Oh. Mad Hatter. That's our nickname. That's our. We have a couple's name.
Cute.
I'm.
It probably would have been.
Oh shit.
You've got it.
Did we see you again? God, chance.
I don't know.
Well, they're trying to hide up against that wall now. We can still see you.
Let's
and intricate
model.
Get it on. Here we go.
They should model.
I've been really trying, baby. Trying to hold back and my soul. And it's you.
Oh, God.
Life.
Northfield is shook.
Northfield.
Jesse James. Is shook. Jesse James is being defeated tonight.
Jesse James. Right.
Zoom in on her face. It's so cute.
She's like falling off.
She's so scared.
I love.
She's terrified.
Look at how happy Jonathan is though.
That's the most candid photo I've ever seen.
Jonathan saved Chi-Chi and Chi-Chi saved him.
Deep. I swear my mom has a mug that says, my dog rescued me.
They had little like paper bags with candles in them. I was wearing a cape. I was a witch.
What age were you?
Like 7. Trick-or-treating, and my cape brushed along this like paper bag with a candle. Right? And they were like, drop and roll! Like everyone I was with, so I had to like, you know, do the whole thing. And it worked!
It's amazing that it works. It's amazing that it works.
And I still have that cape, and it still has like 3
singes.
Wow. Wow.
Damn.
I'm about to carve.
It's
such a tall.
It gets so high.
It's a circus tent, man.
It is literally the best. I love it.
It's natural.
Purgo. Purgo.
You heard it here first, folks. Connie Orchard grows pears.
Are they papples?
Caitlin's here!
Hi!
Look at that Lord of the Rings sweatshirt.
I can't believe they grow pears. Who knew? How was it?
Good.
Right? All right?
Was the pear keep away? The eye doctor?
Yeah. Keeps the ophthalmologist away.
It's like a good crunch.
It's like the crunch of an apple.
It's like the crunch of
an
apple.
And the flavor of a pear.
I usually like my pear.
The best of both worlds.
More ripe.
I think I've only had like pears from a can or like a fruit cup, and that's why I don't like them.
See, the thing is, because they're mushy and the texture is like grainy, and
yes,
I don't like
that's
it.
Fresh pears are where it's at. As a person who eats a lot of pears.
From the County Orchard.
Yeah.
Get those fresh pears.
This is not sponsored by County.
This is 110% sponsored by County Orchard. What's up, Biggie?
It was all a dream! And that's all I know. I'm like the worst.
Cheers!
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 Cutest fireballs I've ever seen. Is that more than one shot?
It's like
that
a shot
like
of half, probably.
Yeah, and everyone looks unhappy.
They're done.
Oh, come on, Addy.
To be fair, that is definitely more.
Woo!
Are you BoJack Horseman?
Yeah.
That is my favorite show.
I love this.
Oh, wait.
This is
good. Cool whip. Whip Nene!
Oh, my God.
What?
Yeah,
it's our next one.
We're
trying
to put on our costumes.
He sucks from Gaga's on. It's a good time.
Gaga is on.
We are
pleased.
Thank
you. So pleased.
Kat's going to cut this out.
This song.
I'm Prince. R.I.P. Why? I love Prince. Prince is perfect. Prince is dead though, so it seems timely.
My costume is pizza. Because it's my personal brand.
Pizza!
Yep.
There you go. Happy Halloween.
Who are you?
I'm dressed
what
as coach.
Are you wearing?
I'm Coach Tim Riggins.
No.
I'm Coach Matthew Saracen.
No.
I'm Coach Jason Street.
No.
I'm Coach Crash Williams.
No. Crash Williams.
What's his name?
Eric Taylor.
Smash Williams.
Smash Williams.
Yeah. Slash Bash Williams.
He's
right?
Coach Eric Taylor.
No.
He's Coach Eric Taylor from Friday Night Lights, and he's difficult.
That's what I am. Difficult. That's
so why Coach Taylor?
Well, one day I was sitting at work, working hard. I received a FaceTime request from Shannon Oz. There she was at Goodwill with Kathleen with this jacket. Very bad reception. So they were like, all right, we got a Halloween costume for you. And in the meantime, I didn't know what I was going to be for Halloween, so if they already found it, that was less work for me. Sounds good.
I'm TJ Guinea. I'm wearing Thomas Magnum from Magnum PI. And I'm wearing it because it's an easy costume. I grew up watching the show, and
where
did you get that mustache?
I got this from Party City. It was like $4.
My name
is Crosby King, but I'm also Biggie Smalls. I'm a legend.
I like it when you call me Big Pop.
Real, the real king.
It's good.
Hey.
I am Ken Bone from the second presidential debate.
Yes.
Hi, my name's Maddie. For Halloween this year,
there
I'm
you go.
Pumpkin.
Oh.
Who doesn't love a good pumpkin?
Did John Kingston die? Did he just get the serious water accident?
I'm Pusheen the cat. I'm a big fan of Pusheen. Love going to the Pusheen Mansion and just being a cat in general. You really get the opportunity to sit on your ass a lot.
So much opportunity.
Eat a lot of tater tot hot dish.
I am a slice of pizza because I love pizza.
You love pizza?
It's like an all.
Everybody.
Another.
Everybody in the club getting chips. Whoop. Oh!
Whoop. My anaconda dope. You have to be close to the club in order to be seen.
My anaconda dope. What?
That's right.
Got buns, hun.
I can't see you.
It's right there. Bryn, what happened? What do you have?
What do you have?
I'm there.
Girl, two shots
you want this dick?
You want to?
In the dirt.
You guys, I think when it howls, we should all howl.
Okay.
Oh no!
Keep working, keep serving, keep working.
The campground was super haunted because there was a guy there.
Tell us the story.
Okay, so he's camping, right?
Tell us the story.
I can't remember. Okay, he lost his hand in a very violent boating accident. And then... So the family got a really cheap rate one weekend because of this guy. Yeah. Three nights for
$29.99. Oh!
Oh. What
a deal!
Wait,
where is
what campground is this? And then all of a sudden, they hear a rustling in the woods, and the little girl's like, "What was that?" And the dad's like, "It's probably the guy with the hook." And then all of a sudden, he holds her!
And she goes to bed, and she hears someone come in the door. She thinks it's just her brother, whatever, he was out with his friends. So she's like, okay, whatever. She goes to bed, and a few minutes later, she's in bed. She sees someone just standing in her doorway.
What?
And at first she's like, oh, it's just Zach, whatever. But it like didn't really look like him, so she was just like, blood-curdling scream. Like,
oh my god, because he was a ghost.
Is she still
alive? It's probably just a creepy dude.
Is she still alive?
Yeah, she's still alive.
Just checking.
The little girl in the family, she, like, you know, took the fever or something. And
was it the plague? Or?
So they dug up the grave. And when they were digging it up, it fell open, and they saw scratch marks inside.
And she starts to freak out. So she's searching the whole house, and finally she goes into the bathroom, and they're both hanging in the shower, and so is the dog. And written in blood on the floor is, not only a dog can lick your hand.
Oh. And then all of a sudden, immediately after, like, I looked over at my hand turned over, and towards the curtain or whatever, my hand turned over, I could feel his, like, hand on me.
Well, if you go to Taiwan in the mountains, there's always like little guard lions on the side because they're like haunted by dead ghosts. That's the belief. There are ghosts wandering around the mountains. So there are things happen. So there's a stretch of the road because there's many turns. So people die easily because there's many car crashes. So it's haunted, but it's not really haunted. It's just lots of turns. But people say
it's too practical for there to be haunted.
But people say you don't want to go drive that stretch of the road at night because like scary things really happen. So
well,
some people try
doors.
Their best to drive the stretch of mountain in the morning, or they take other route. But if you drive through the mountain, it's the fastest way to go through the middle part of Taiwan. So people still do that. So sometimes, in the middle of the tunnel, you can hear people like going on the car hood, like this kind of sound.
Ooh.
And then
shit.
While you're in the car,
you want to keep going. And then people say, in the morning when they finally stop, they see like handprints. There's a group of friends.
Ooh, there's an anecdote.
So there's a group of friends. What happened is that they were driving, and then they saw the lady on the side waving at them. So then they're like, oh, someone's waving. So
the bus.
And the lady's like, oh, I just needed a ride. I need to get to the bottom of the mountain.
In the white dress?
Yep, the lady in the white dress. So they let her into the car because there's an empty seat.
No.
Seats taken. No.
How did they do that?
So I keep on driving. People in the front started kind of like worrying. They're like, oh, is this the ghost? Why are you up in the mountain at the first place? Because she's like, oh, I'm just waiting for people. I'm waiting for people to pick me up. Next morning, they saw the car just tip over on the side of the road. Four people in it. One of them survived, so that's how they know the story. But three other people die. And then you can see there's like bloody handprint inside the car.
So they tried to get out.
They tried to get out, but they couldn't. So then one person left, so they know. Don't pick up a lady.
It's Stranger Danger, not a cultural concept.